one person realizes the shirt off his back was taken, everybody in that office and department and building will know about it. And they'll all be thinking twice before they carry on in the same fashion.
Oh yeah, like I said, man, you're right, it's going to make them think twice. It's like I said, it's like when, it's like when you see, even said, like, the Nuremberg trial, it made the whole world stop and think. It's like, wait a second, these soldiers were just carrying out their orders. Wait a second, now you're hanging them, doing what they were ordered to do. You know, like I said, that was a hell of a trial. Because you just can't blindly do what you're told to do. You still have to realize that you're trespassing upon another man. You still have to realize what you're doing is wrong. You know, so just because you got a badge and they told you to go do it, you still better stop and you better think, wait a second, how would I like somebody to jump over my fence? How would I like somebody to put up my gate? How would I like somebody to trespass on my private property? How would I like somebody to do that to me? You know, it makes you pause and stop and think. And that's what every cop is supposed to do before they do what they do. They're supposed to stop and think. You know, not only do they, okay, I got a gun and a badge, and they said they ordered me to go, you know, shoot into the crowd, just start shooting indiscriminately. Well, they're Romanians, they're gypsies, just start shooting. You know, what do you mean?
It's interesting you say that. You may not have got the news over in America, but there was a case that happened, you know, our London riots that happened, was it a year, 2 years ago? And it all kind of kicked off because some black guy was basically shot dead by armed police in central London, and the family were obviously distraught. They went to the police station, and with them came their friends, and before they knew it, they weren't happy with the responses. It escalated, and before you knew it, London riot happened and riots all over England. The equivalent of your Rodney King thing, I suppose. And his trial happened a couple of days ago, and it turned out that he was killed lawfully for the people of life, even though he's unarmed, so shot him dead.
Right.
I thought it was quite interesting, because the picture of the background is the Royal Court of Justice, where you went. So I was thinking, that's interesting, wonder what kind of car they got. Did they go through the place? I wonder what they had
for. It was a inquest, it wasn't a trial stuff.
Yeah, that's what I noticed, I was listening out to the roads, and then I had to watch it a few times, and then it said it was an inquest, and then I was realising, oh, okay, so, yeah, unfortunately, they're not going to get the justice for them, they're going to get whatever.
See, because the family doesn't know what I know. All the families, yeah, like the O.J. Simpson case here in the United States, just because he was found not guilty in one court, he was found guilty in another court. He was found liable in a civil court against the Goldman family, and what was his wife's last name? I can't remember his wife's last name, but the waiter guy, he was a Goldman, and I don't remember what the girl's last name was, but O.J. killed two people, but he was found liable for civil damages. So like I said, what the family could do, that black guy's family could do, is they could sue the guy in Queens Bench for civil damages.
And that's what I was noticing straight away. The inquest is obviously going to be, not necessarily whitewashed all the time, but obviously this one didn't work in that favor.
Oh yeah, obviously the inquest is going to find that the cop was totally within he was doing his job. The same thing that's going to be found if Barry Rose had an inquest before Coventry Council, you know, the members of the council were going to say he was totally within the letter of the law. But like I said, in the common land and the common law still says you can't trespass on a person's property even if you got a badge. And that's what I was telling you earlier when we were talking about it. It's like, oh, you're a landlord. You are so screwed. Because there's so many laws on the books to protect the tenants, to protect the little guy in England. It's scary. So the little guy is so protected in England, it's scary. You know, the big evil landlord, you know, obviously when, you know, the Commons and the Parliament got together, obviously there's a lot more poor people who said no, you know. It's like you guys always have those crazy, what, the Labour Party and the Tories or whatever you guys got?
Yeah.
And the Labour Party obviously is always going to find for the, you know, the little guy, you know, right. and you guys who are landlords are always going to lose when the Labor Party's in place. You guys are always going to be taxed to the eyeballs.
Yeah,
it's pretty funny. It's the same thing we have over here with the Democrats and Republicans. It's the same damn thing that happens in this country. The Democrats give everybody free handouts for every freaking thing because those are the people who vote for them. Yeah.